30. It's almost comparable to a man that was a child that was born 30 years ago. And I tell you the truth, from 1987 till today, Aquarium has done so well. It could have been better. But believe you me, Aquarium was not done bad. At 30, age of maturity, age of crossing over, it looks like, and I think Aquarium is ready to increase its speed. So far, so good. But then I believe that at 30, our speed is going to increase, going to get better. And at 30, we've not done very badly. When we compare ourselves with other states that we created, some earlier than us, one of them, the same year with us, the same date, I don't think we've done badly in the Committee of States in Nigeria. Well, if you exclude the military that we had no control over, those ones were imposed because it was a military arrangement. And most of them were brought in from diverse backgrounds. I would tell you that beginning of the democracy, this particular dispensation of 1999 today, at every point in time, God has given us the leader that we truly deserve at a point in time. When Obonbi Tutu in 1999 came on board as an architect, he began the process of redrawing Aquarium State. He may not have completely started the building process, but at the stage his tenure was over. Victor Attal left the baton to Obongodwu Oborokpabio, who came with the transformation, they call it transformation idea, began to build some of the roads, some of the major highways we have, and structures all over the place. So you can see that from the formative stage under democracy of planning what the state should look like to the next stage of beginning to build the state with infrastructure, with roads, with buildings, we've now entered the third phase, the stage of industrialization. So you can now see that there's been a gradual growth process. First, designing what we would look like, the basic things that we needed, like a port, like some of the road that goes to be built, Attal designed it. Now, having moved into that construction stage, he handed over the baton. This other man says, we want to build industries, but then we still need a few more infrastructure in certain locations to ensure that when these industries come, the basic concept of economics 101 is that before you build an industry, some roads that were built were not interconnected. What is this administration doing? Interconnecting those roads. If you come to Aquarium, it's not just the concept of building roads, it's the concept of building a network of roads that we're doing side by side with the industrialization drive. Don't allow anybody to deceive you. If you cannot manage the simple basic industries like the toothpick factory that people are saying all manners of things about, if they give you a refinery, you cannot manage it. So Aquarium has started well by going for the basic industries, the basic factories that provide the basic things. I mean, as an officer who was in the customs, when toothpick used to be imported into our country, I used to feel very embarrassed. So if Aquarium has taken the bull by the horn and said, look, you do not need to import it, we're producing it right here. Things like pencil. As simple as pencil is, if you look at the volume of pencil that we imported into Nigeria over the years, you'll be embarrassed. Aquarium has started at those basic things. Now Aquarium has gone to one item that we consume in the millions, hundreds of millions, called syringe. A few days ago I was sick. Doctor that came around to treat me would use almost 3 syringes before he could get to the one they would put on my body. They would use 2 to do the mixing. They used the other one. And the entirety of it was imported from Asia. And a little portion of it from South Africa. Now, this government has brought in investors. We now have a syringe factory. Premeter is one of the reasons why we are having problems with power holding. If we were to have sufficient premeter, estimated bills would end. So His Excellency the Governor has done what he calls housekeeping. Looking at those things that people consider minor, but has become part and parcel of the human being. It's like people producing distilled water, ever water. You know what? You can't do without water. The volume of water consumed daily means that water will continually be in production. So His Excellency is not just excited about building gigantic factories that we may not even have the immediate manpower to man them. It's going to the basis. And from the basis, you can now build the superstructures. If you want to build a superstructure and you've not laid a good foundation, it's bound to fail. So what Akwaibom has done is that while completing the road network, we're beginning to build simple, but factories that all humans need. Is there anybody that will not use strange? The day you show up in hospital, no matter who you are, you will use strange. That means the consumption of strange from Akwaibom is compulsory for all Nigerians. If you eat, if you go to restaurants, you must use toothpick. Every child who goes to primary school beginning to learn the process of writing must use pencil. He will not use pen so that he doesn't condemn the books. If Nigeria must get to a stable level in power generation, supply, and usage, there must be perimeter so that you can consume or pay as you consume, unlike when whether you have light or not, they give you estimated bill, which is generating a lot of problem. So what we are doing, what His Excellency the Governor, Oyedepo Emmanuel, has done in Akwa Ibom, is to look at those basic things that we're taking for granted and bring them to bear. I will call them housekeeping, foundation lay, but industrialization drive of this government is upward looking. If this could be achieved in 2 years of economic recession, a few days ago I read that economic recession, Nigeria is coming out of recession. It means our income and resources available will increase. I tell you that come 2019, His Excellency the Governor will have sufficient things in terms of infrastructure to show to Akwaibom people and the entire world. He will have been able to convince Akwaibom people that he didn't just mouth industrialization, he meant every word of it.